now I get to try out playing Jedi Knight 2. Oh, that's cool. Yeah, I actually made some suggestions on his Patreon yesterday, and he actually wrote back and agreed with some of them, but some of the games that I would have loved being given VR playability. A lot of them are Unreal Engine and older Unreal Engine, and probably won't be possible. Although there is one coming out for Unreal Engine 4. I forget the name of it, but it will, it should be able to give VR playability to one of my favorite games that calms me down when anxiety's bad, and it's Abzu. If you've never played Abzu, Abzu would be perfect for VR. Anyway, I just realized that I'm just watching the words turn into tiny specks. It looks like they're hitting the planet now. Yeah, they're gone. Alright, so, let's start a new game. It feels like, on that menu screen, it feels like, I don't know. It was like my hand and the pointer weren't quite as, like, I could move my hand more than the pointer was moving. Probably one of those bugs that get worked out. This is a pretty early release. I must say, I've for years had trouble running this game on Windows 10. I think I might have had some trouble on Windows 7 as well. And there's one thing that is nice about these VR ports is a lot of them in the process of getting them working in VR, they work out a lot of these game ports. Cutscene looks great. Oh, wow, it looks really good.
Preparing for final approach. Whatever's causing those transmissions, it's not showing up on any of the sensors. This Imperial outpost looks as abandoned as reported.
It's as dead as the rest of Ketchum. My Mothma must be getting paranoid. She never used to send pros like us out on blue milk runs like this.
And nowadays, they would have made the skybox bigger.
Greetings.
Mon Mothma, Kyle was just talking about you.
Literally as big as
no doubt. I bring troubling information about your mission on Kejim.
I hate it when you say troubling.
We've managed to decode a small fraction of the transmission we intercepted earlier. And, well, listen for yourselves.
I will fire. Shadow. We may have to... The Valley of the Jedi. Reborn Warrior.
Let's see. Everything looks great.
The Valley of the Jedi?
Everything looks
Reborn?
We believe this transmission was intended for Galak Fyar, the suspected leader of the remnant forces in that sector. It's probably nothing more than a couple of soldiers telling tales around the glow lamp. But as you are the only survivors of the Valley of the Jedi incident, I thought it only fair to warn you that this mission may be more dangerous than we originally anticipated. Your objectives, however, remain the same. Find out what you can, clear out any remnant forces you encounter, and may the Force be with you.
It's kind of checking
so
out.
So much for the blue milk run.
The whole skybox deal.
I think I saw someone.
Oh, wow, check that out. I I am really here, and I'm holding a... What is this? The Briar Blaster? It was something like that.
This is my last day on this ship.
Oh, yeah? Where are you moving?
Sector 7 had an opening, so I apply.
Oh, Ben. Should be a quiet last day.
First-person shooters were still pretty simple. Yeah. Why can't I get that? And it won't let me walk through that barrier. I guess I gotta kill these dudes.
Blasters aren't going to do much good against that.
I'll see if I can find a way to get the door open. Wait here, Jan.
The Remnant usually has pretty tight security. Make sure you search any officers for key cards.
Oh, that's alt fire. The B button is alt fire. What do I do to use this? That's like the... Oh, there we go. Yeah, I gotta push on the right stick. to think. I'm bad about hoarding those, and, yeah. Bad about hoarding them, not using them, and then I get so many of them that it won't let me pick up anymore, so I start having to go, okay, well, that's wasting them too.
One way to do it.
Stay here, Jen. Cover our back.
Okay, I'll wait here. Don't take all day.
Give up. Escape.
This is awesome. I love it. I swear, I thought that was a switch. Got a supply.
I think this is a primary control console. Got it. I think I'll hang out here a while and see what kind of trouble I can cause.
Yeah, you do that.
Spread out and find you.
Yeah, this is a really well done mod.
Kyle, the schematics show that the base is divided into three sections.
That was cute. That's a cute touch. I don't remember that being in the original game, but it was usually too dark in here to pay any attention to anything anyway. Yeah, this was like one of the best games ever made. And to be able to play this in VR is just incredible. I've had this mod for a few days, but I was putting it off. I don't know why.
It's offline. It's offline.
Everything's offline. cool that I can dodge the shot.
Come on, now.
Come on, open that door. I was thinking maybe I could select it right there. That's just crouch. Yeah, I can't figure what that might be.
It's offline.
Amplification goggles to work. Well, I'm gonna have to do some research and find out if what I'm experiencing with, I basically can't find any way to interact with the find a way to interact with the items. I'm pretty sure there's somewhere I have to go to.
Looks like an Imperial code.
Finish the gun. Alright, so.
It's offline. It's offline.
Yep.
Jan, I'm gonna need your help. There's an access terminal here, but it's encoded.
I'm on my way. Kyle, I'm pinned down. Get back here and give me a hand.
Alright, that's a good place to stop the video. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed this, because I certainly did. Y'all have a good night.